in this regard, I think, as I told, I would appreciate all of you for participating in this particular workshop. And my request to all of you is these 3 days to participate actively and interact with the resource persons and try to clarify whatever doubts you have regarding these sensors, the design and applications. For any societal applications, you might have seen what is important for sensor. For example, even COVID-19 also, there is a thermal sensor to know the temperature. If the thermal sensor is not working properly, then we may not identify the persons those are having the virus. So likewise, any of the applications you take, the sensor is very, very crucial part in that water equipment, as you all know that. So by knowing, understanding that importance, I am requesting all of you to participate actively in the workshop. And I would like to thank, I think, some of the Siddhartha faculty and some of the faculty from CRAT and our own faculty members also reached for this particular one. So within a short time, you people responded. That is very nice. At the same time, I would like to thank resource persons also. Within 2 days, they have responded and acting and accepting our invitation to act as resource persons is very great, sir. So I am appreciating the Department of VAE also for conducting this particular 3-day FDP. So I am expecting the deliberations in this workshop are going to be fruitful and at the same time useful for the mankind to develop the sensors in more economical, more economically. So that is my wish. Okay. So I wish you all the best. I'd like to conclude by this and over to Purna Garu. So resource persons can take care or Purna Garu. And I would like to appreciate Naik Garu also. Yes, sir. The coordinator has taken so many pains to conduct this particular workshop within a short time. So I would like to appreciate all of you. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to the principal, sir. And we're very thankful to the resource persons, those who are accepting our invitation, Yogesh Chandra and Ramchandra Garu. Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone. And the session will be continued and hand over to the Chandra, manager, testing engineer, Magna Automotive, Germany. Thank you. Thank you. Sir, Yogesh Chandra Garu, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. I would like to thank our principal, sir, K. Apparao Garu, and our HOD, sir, Purna Garu, and Nayak, sir, to give this opportunity. Actually, I will be privileged that the knowledge that I have was being shared to somebody. Thank you very much for the opportunity, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
So my topic on which I was about to talk was like the sensors in automotive applications. Nowadays, automotive industry has become in such a way that everything, whatever the mechanical parts are being replaced by electronic parts to achieve more efficiency and more accuracy. For example, in olden days and all, if you see, we have carburetors in cars and even lorries before, but they were replaced by electronic fuel injections, and nowadays they are also replaced in two-wheelers as well to improve the efficiency, fuel efficiency and all. So for example, if you take that small part of electronic fuel injection itself, that itself will have lot of electronic lot of embedded systems. For example, for an embedded system to work, the main part that is needed, the two parts that are needed are the measurement and the actuation. So the measurement will happen only through sensors. So we all know that how sensors are crucial in any system to work. So I'll start with the automotive the sensors in automotive applications, and I request you all, like, if you have any doubts, please stop me anywhere and you can ask. I think somebody is sharing the screen. Can you please switch off the screen sharing so that I can share my screen? Hello.
Sir, Max, sir. Hello. Sir, somebody they shared some screen share. That screen, sir. Sir will be shared some screen.
Yes sir, I got it. Thank you.
Are you okay sir? Okay now sir? Okay sir?
Yes sir. Yes sir. Yes
okay,
sir. Thank you. So we all know like what are the basic principles of sensors and so are you able to see my screen like the presentation?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. So I'm sorry, please don't call me sir. I'm just very small in age. I'm one of your students. So inside the temperature sensor and this outer part is of copper and gold. Is made up of copper and gold, which senses the temperature very high. So this is how it looks like. And this is stupidity. Like I thought I was showing you the screen and I was explaining. Sorry. So this is how the exhaust gas recirculation temperature is present. So this is the exhaust manifold from where for example you have your engine here, and the exhaust gases are passing through this exhaust manifold like this, and they are passed through this EGR gas valve, and they are sent back to the inlet valve again to achieve maximum combustion that is happening. Generally, what happens is during combustion, I know that our students we have this thermodynamics and fluid mechanics subject in second year first semester. So during that time we have this subject where the Carnot cycle, the functioning of engine and all are explained. So sir, is this subject still going or is it there in the curriculum? Okay, so you know all right, like okay sir. Then the inlet the exhaust valve from the exhaust valve the gases are sent back through this EGR valve to have a turbocharge. So generally in Carnot cycle we see that we have 100% efficiency, but that is an ideal character. Till now the maximum efficiency the maximum combustion that has happened in the fuel is 46% only the fuel that enters into the engine the 46% of the fuel that is entering into the engine is combusted and rest of all is evaporated because of the temperature that is present inside the chamber. So the evaporated gases comes out here and they settle down and that is why this black foil that is present inside the exhaust pipe. So to avoid that, generally what they do is they pass some of the gases again back to the engine. So during that time we need to measure the temperature of this gases. So that temperature is being measured by the same sensor. Like same in the means two different sensors but of same principle, thermistor. So then pressure sensing for automotive applications. So we have this MEMS sensors. These all are the MEMS sensors, and these are the auto parts where it is present, and this is application. So we have a pressure sensor for air intake, pressure sensor for internal pressure of the cylinder, oxygen sensor to reflect the concentration of engine's combustible gas. And this is also an engine assembly. Engine assembly means, as I told you earlier, the pipe also comes into the exhaust pipe also comes into the engine assembly. And then crankshaft position sensor. The crankshaft position sensor means so that we all know that we have four strokes in inlet, suction stroke, inlet stroke, suction stroke, combustion stroke, and then exhaust stroke. These are the four strokes. For each and every stroke, the position of the piston changes. So when the position of the piston changes, so the inlet of the fuel should also be in such a way that depending on the position of the position of your piston only, this should be done. So the injection of the fuel should be done. So for that, to know the position, we need a crankshaft position sensor. So then the throttle positions, and throttle is like how much acceleration you are giving, how much intake of the fuel is happening, that is measured by throttle position sensor. And then the speed sensor, this is measured for engine RPM. And then water temperature sensor, I already told you that we have water tank which is circulating the water to the glycol to reduce the temperature of the glycol, that is engine coolant. And then acceleration sensor for airbag systems, and then pressure sensor for airbag, pressure sensor for braking system. At how much pressure you have applied the brake, that also is measured. Because to control the oil, depending on your application of the pressure, the oil movement, the actuator will be pumping the oil into the brake pads. So that for that also you need a pressure sensor. And then pressure sensor to know the suspension pressure, how much pressure the suspension is taking it, because we have some active suspension systems. I think if you have ever seen this Volvo buses and all, during their movement, they just pull up and pull down. So there'll be movement like this. So that is happening because of active suspension system. And then tire pressure monitoring system. I told you earlier. I'll explain you. That is a very good, interesting subject, interesting sensor, and very very advanced MEMS sensor. Very advanced MEMS sensor it is. And then wheel speed sensor, for traction control. And tilt sensor, whether the chassis is tilting or not, how much stable the chassis is. And then gyro for navigation. Nowadays it is present in all, even our mobiles. So I'll explain you each and every application. So intake pressure sensor. So how much intake is happening? How much air pressure intake is happening? That is measured using this intake manifold sensor. So in that you have, I'll explain you. So you have a thick film pressure sensor present at this point in opposite to the intake fuel. So when it is when the intake is happening, so this thick film, this film will be sensing the temperature, will be sensing the pressure. For example, the pressure is applied like this, and then and then the depending on this, the strain is measured by the strain gauge. It is a strain gauge principle, and then the strain is measured, and this strain is directly proportional to the pressure of the intake. So for this, we have a film, thick film with a ceramic substrate. Ceramic plate is present on that, and this tilting, this when the pressure is applied on this, the movement of this is strain. This strain is proportional to the change in resistance, and that change in resistance is proportional to the change in voltage. So here indirectly the change in pressure is directly proportional to the change in voltage. So this is how thick film pressure, this intake pressure sensor works. And then we have one more pressure sensor for the same thick film. So here we have this diaphragm. As I told you, diaphragm will be like this. And when you for example, what is diaphragm? If you see a speaker, that the film on that speaker, if you see, it will be when it is pumping the sound, the speaker will be moving like this. It will be vibrating like this. The cloth around that is a diaphragm. So it will be very sensitive that a small pressure is also changed into a displacement. So when this pressure is boosting like this, so when it is changing, so here it shows, it tilts the diaphragm. So when the diaphragm will be like this, and it will be tilting like this. So this tilt, so are you able to see my screen? Yeah, see me. This tilt is change in the displacement. This pressure is changing into a displacement here. So this displacement is again a potentiometer there, present a potentiometer present there. So this is how generally a strain gauge works. So we have this strain gauge circuit here. So this is how the signal conditioning, and then the comparator circuit, and then the measure voltage will be proportional to the pressure applied here. Sorry, is that fine, sir? I have already crossed 1.5 hour.
Okay, no problem. I'll continue. Otherwise, if it is tomorrow also, you have to 1.5 hour class.
Yeah, sir. Yes.
So if done that one, you have to plan that. Suppose you have to continue, no problem.
From here, force sensors and torque sensors, I'll continue tomorrow, sir. Is that fine?
Okay.
Sir. And any doubts on this till now? Sorry, I was. It's my mistake that I did not show you the presentation. This presentation.
Okay, no problem.
Yes, sir.
So I request any faculty to interact with you. Okay. Do you have any doubts?
And the PPTs I have already shared with Nayak sir.
Okay. Thank you. Request any faculty to interact with Yogesh. Any doubt regarding any?
So tomorrow timing? Same timing, sir?
Same time. So I request all the participants, to send your details. That means your name, what is the position of your in your college, and which college you have. These three details will be sent through WhatsApp.
Yeah, I have some questions in the chat box.
What is the number we need to send, sir?
My number is 944-1049. Otherwise, you note down that one. My number is 944-1049. 42920.
Okay.
Send your details, Yogesh. That means you want to express some doubts. All that means some of the raise their doubts. Participants. That means you have.
Yes, sir.
That means Yogesh can explain.
Can we use oxygen sensor to measure the quality of air? Yes, we can measure the quality of air. Sir, what is drowsiness sensor? For drowsiness sensor, we don't have any sensors actually. For drowsiness, how the drowsiness is measured is like you have a camera present in front of you, or a camera present in your steering, and depending on this image processing system, so when you are drowsy, your eyes will be closing like this, or your change, there will be change in your face properties. So the change in the face properties are compared with the face. So for example, if you see you have nowadays, you have all of you might have the phones that are used for sensing your face lock. You will have the same principle is used. That's what the
Yogesh.
Sir,
can you explain any what that means? Any design of any one of the sensor?
Sir,
I think that means design for parties. Why because
morning actually I'm not into.
Okay, design.
I'm not.
Okay, no problem.
I'm not into design, sir. Actually, I work for BMW, and for them only I do the testing during driving, sir. So for that.
Okay. No problem. No. You have any idea regarding that?
But I can get you the knowledge, sir. Like I can get some from somebody whom I know, and I'll explain.
Okay. That will be explained tomorrow class. That is the minimum.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So we'll be explaining tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So today, I think it is over. Otherwise, we'll be continuing.
Sir, one more question, sir. Sir, is there any mechanism to open doors automatically based on gas sensing? Yes. Yes. They have this gas sensing. Carbon monoxide will be sensed in that the gas sensors, and that carbon monoxide. Sensor will be a same chemical sensor, and that chemical sensor will give you a voltage from that sensor to ECU, and ECU will actuate the opening of doors. Yeah, we have a mechanism for that. Sir,
any other
Sir, can you suggest me if we if we